Skull and Bones was thoroughly shown at the latest Ubisoft Forward event, and let me tell you guys, I think that it looks awesome, but I've also seen some people comparing it to Star Citizen, calling it Star Citizen on the Sea, and so having a main channel entirely dedicated to Star Citizen, I've decided to take a deep look and see if the comparison is justified or not. So, what is Skull and Bones, you may ask? Well, it is an open world or open sea MMO tactical combat game that can be played at a third or first person. You'll start out at the lowest point of the ladder with a tiny vessel and no crew, and you will have to make your way to the top of the food chain and become the most infamous pirate in history. To do so, you will have to successfully complete missions that would have been given to you, or explore the world to find riches and treasures, hunt and gather resources, and eventually raid settlements and forts to plunder them all while having to check over your shoulders for privateers and other players being out there to hunt you down. And while I do understand that the way the game gives you the freedom to do whatever you want in a game, like for example being the captain of your ship, this might give you a similar vibe to Star Citizen, and we can already spot some major differences that set both games apart. First, Skull and Bones will not offer a 100% seamless experience in which you'll be able to fully move your character everywhere you want and perform every task there is to do aboard your ship. For example, you will not be personally firing cannons or dueling with a cutlass other players during the combat sequence. This will be simulated by the game instead. Next, let's talk about character progression, which is here radically different. In Star Citizen, progression is based on how good you become at the game itself and your very own objectives within the game. Do you want to improve your reputation within a faction? Do you want to buy a bigger and more powerful ship? In Skull and Bones, however, progression is based on your level of infamy, which increases or decreases based on how successful or terrible you are at being a pirate, which is a concept that I just find hilarious. I love the idea of being rewarded with the game progression for being a scummy pirate, and based on the footage that was revealed to us at the Ubisoft Forward, it just looks so much fun with so much happening everywhere all the time, either on your ship, with your crew, or on the sea, with the weather or the wildlife you will encounter, and of course with combat, which appears to be wonderfully chaotic with explosions and destructions everywhere. I'm really loving everything I'm seeing. Then, I would say that the next big difference would be the fundamentals of the game, which itself here, I think the biggest being the PvP slider, which will allow players who desire so to avoid any kind of player versus player combat, just like what Elite Dangerous has been doing for years already. Of course, that's not possible in Star Citizen, where player-to-player interactions are an essential part of the game, while Skull and Bones can be played solo if you desire to do so. Finally, I would say that another major difference between Star Citizen and Skull and Bones would be your relationship with your ship, as crafting will be an essential part of Skull and Bones and will allow you to not only build your own ship, but also customize it with armor, weapons, and aesthetics the way you want it to be, while in Star Citizen, you just buy your ship and the extra components that you wish to upgrade it with, and that's basically it. There isn't much bonding or emotional attachment with them, or at least not as much as what the developers at Ubisoft Singapore hoped there would be with their ships in Skull and Bones. But now that is being said here, I think that there are also some similarities between both games, and we're going to talk about them right now. The first one is not really gameplay related, as we are going to talk about here the development cycle of the game, which, just like Star Citizen, has been rather chaotic to say the least. Skull and Bones development started in 2019, 9 years ago and just 1 year after Star Citizen, and just like Star Citizen, has had to deal with several major redesigns to be more entertaining and also up to date with current game tech. To me, this is perhaps the biggest similarity I can see between both games, as the game was supposed to be released in 2018 and was then delayed to 2019, 2020, and now scheduled to be playable by us at least on November 8th of this year, and that is of course if everything goes right. And just like Star Citizen, Skull and Bones has been a very expensive game to make. I've read, for example, that so far Ubisoft has spent $120 million in development alone, and that did not include, of course, marketing yet. And yet, we're still quite far from Star Citizen's $500 million, but still $120 million makes Skull and Bones a very expensive game to make, and it better be good for Ubisoft to secure a return on investment, or the shareholders certainly will make it painful for CEO Yves Guillermo. The next similar point, in my opinion, are the attention to details that we have been able to spot in the clips that were shown. Skull and Bones aims at bringing elements of realism in order to make the game as immersive as possible. Take the starting location of Sainte Anne in the Indian Ocean. Well, it turns out that it is a real location in the Seychelles. A lot of the items and foods that we are also going to use in the game are actually inspired from real-life foods and items from the various locations that we'll get to visit in our adventures. I love to see that the Dutch company of the East Indies seems to be a major antagonist, just how they were a major force in this point of the world at that particular time. Skull and Bones is not going to rely on magics to cheat on certain aspects of a pirate's life, just like Star Citizen avoids doing the same with our own interpretation of a spacer's life. Finally, let's talk about the elephant in the room, microtransactions, and with such an insane budget, I can't imagine that Ubisoft don't have a plan to monetize extra content or pay to skip mechanics, which is a common practice for a game of this type. Star Citizen, for example, infamously offers you to buy ships, some worth over $1,000. You can also purchase paint jobs or even in-game currency, and while I don't think that we'll get to buy ships in Skull and Bones since the process of building your ship is so important in the game, you will probably also be able to purchase cosmetics and in-game currency, but to what extent, well, hey, that of course remains to be seen at this stage. So there you have it, guys, the reasons why one could see some similarities between Skull and Bones and Star Citizen. And despite both games being rather different at their core, I guess that, you know, it is somewhat fashionable to compare Star Citizen with other big budget games that have been in development for a very long time. To me, that's not much of a concern. I love what I saw, and I am very excited about this game, especially since I come from Saint-Malo in Brittany, a notorious pirate city, where famous corsair Robert Surcouf made a name for himself sailing the very seas that we will get to roam for ourselves. But let me know in the comment section down below, guys, do you see any similarities between both games? Are you excited for Skull and Bones, or perhaps are you disappointed with the direction the game has taken? Tell me everything in the comment section down below. Of course, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to the channel to see more gaming content. I wish you guys a wonderful day. It's been The Eradicator, and I will see you guys later.